I remember one of your key concerns in that night in June was that you were concerned about his use of loose language. That hasn't gone away, has it?
Well, I believe actually he's been pretty focused in the period that we've had since.
What about when he dismissed a female MP's concerns about aggressive language fueling violence as humbug? You wouldn't have liked that, would you?
No, I didn't like that. And I think, you know, we are in an environment just now where we all have to be very careful and considered about what we say. And I think he did actually subsequently realise that that wasn't a sensible thing to have said. But, you know, Colin, this election is not about simply personalities. It's
about
key issues.
It's about trust, isn't it? Every election is about trust to some degree.
Well, yeah, and you've asked me, do I trust him in the work he's doing as Prime Minister? And the answer is yes.
And yet he misled the Queen in terms of the illegal prorogation of Parliament. You've got a picture of the Queen in your office in the Parliament, haven't you?
No.
Haven't you? I thought you had. But, you know, you're a big fan of the royals. You wouldn't be terribly keen on him lying to the Queen, would you?
Like the majority of the country,
Colin. Yes, but you wouldn't be happy about misleading the Queen, would you?
And I obviously wouldn't want to see the Queen misled. But I believe that the Prime Minister, in the way that he has dealt with me and in response to the points I have put to him, has responded and delivered on what he said he would do.